Bishop Paprocki, Jim Lee with WMNY Radio here in Springfield. Obviously, a big change of pace coming from the hustle and bustle of Chicago to Springfield. How do you make that adjustment?
Well, I look forward to getting to know a lot of people here, and I'm sure that that in itself will be a challenge. So moving into a new community, I've known that from past experience, becoming pastor of a new parish. And I've been pastor of a large parish. I've also served in small parishes. And I've always found that wherever you are, that it's a wonderful thing that you have the opportunity to meet a lot of people. And I'm sure regardless of the size of the diocese compared to the archdiocese, that there'll be many, many wonderful people here that will fill my time in the months and years ahead, getting to meet you and getting to know you. Well, I think you will see just a little bit in the description that you've heard of me already is that I have a wide variety of interests. So in my ministry, I have not necessarily focused on any one particular thing like a specialty. I have, for example, as a special interest of mine, been involved with legal services for the poor. So as a parish priest, I went to study civil law at DePaul University College of Law. And so I was not a lawyer before I became a priest. I went to law school as a priest, which some people found to be a bit interesting. Why was I doing that? The reason why I did that was because of my belief in what the church teaches about caring for the poor and the commitment for the poor, that our concern for caring for the poor, what Pope John Paul II used to call the option for the poor, is something that should really be an essential part of our ministry. So that's what I wanted to do with, as a special sort of focus with my ministry. And I was doing that and continue to do that with legal services for the poor. But I've, in the course of the years, also got involved in other kinds of interests and ministries that have really captured my enthusiasm. One of the more recent ones that I've gotten involved with is a group called Catholic Athletes for Christ, and it's a group that tries to work in bringing together the world of sports and faith, and I found that because of my interest in sports to be kind of a natural connection. Since becoming a bishop, I have also found myself very energized by the ministry of confirmation. As I go into parishes and I meet young people, it energizes me, and I try to be a presence of Christ's love to them and to bring to them the message of the Holy Spirit. So those are some of the areas that I've spent some particular time and attention, but I wouldn't say that I've been involved in any one thing to the exclusion of others. I try to do as much as I can through a variety of areas.
Yes. Your appointment comes at a time when the Catholic Church is back in the headlines, not always in the most positive ways. Do you see that as an issue that needs to be addressed, a rebuilding of trust or faith with the community?
Definitely. We definitely need to be addressing these issues. I have served for 10 years as the Cardinal's delegate to our professional review board in the Archdiocese of Chicago, working with allegations of sexual misconduct with minors, and so I know what a painful and what a troubling issue that this sin and this crime is that confronts us in the church. And as the Cardinal's delegate, when I began as Chancellor in 1992, we instituted some of the first policies in trying to deal with this problem, policies that other dioceses also were instituting at that time. We were one of the first archdioceses to have an assistance ministry for victims of sexual abuse. So this is something that I have put a lot of time and energy into, and I pledge that I will continue to do what I can to help the church in this regard.
Bishop Andrew Hansen from WICS-TV 150,000 Catholics, probably half of them actually go to Mass. If you could address how you're going to try to bring Catholics back to the faith and also more vocations to priesthood.
Great, thank you very much. That is an important issue as well. Well, one of the ways that we are trying to look at that across the country, the Archdiocese of Chicago participated in a project that other dioceses did, the Diocese of Rockford, the Diocese of Joliet, in Illinois, the Diocese of Gary, in Indiana, and so in that region there. But also in other dioceses in Phoenix, for example, I think first did the pilot project a year ago, of a program called Catholics Come Home. And there was a series of television spots that were run on primetime television and throughout the day on major television outlets during the Christmas season and into the new year. And so this was a way of outreaching to people, and it's a message that we need to continue to deliver to people about the importance of our participation in the life of the church, and in particular by going to Mass on Sunday. That doing so is not something that we do just because the church says we should do it, but because God actually says that to us in one of the Ten Commandments, that we should honor the Sabbath, which we do by going to Mass on Sunday. And so that's something also that we need to continue to work on. In terms of the, what was your second question?
Vocations.
On vocations. Yes, definitely. I think that vocations are something that we need to spend a lot of time and energy on. We have a wonderful vocations director, Father Christopher House, right here at Holy Name Cathedral. I look forward to working with him. And I'm looking forward also to meeting our seminarians that we have for the Diocese of Springfield. And so I'll be working with Father House and with the vocation staff to try to look at ways and how we can continue to promote vocations to priesthood, to religious life, to married life, and to many, many ways that people serve God and each other.
Bishop, Amanda Reedy from the State Journal Register. On the subject of clergy, we hear that there's a shortage and there's talk of consolidation, particularly among a lot of the smaller rural communities, which are here in the diocese. What's your position on that? And is that something that you foresee will have to happen more in the diocese?
I'm sorry, can you repeat the question?
Sure. With the shortage of clergy, yes. You hear a lot of talk about consolidation for churches, particularly in small rural areas. What's your position on that? And is that something that you think will have, a trend that's going to continue here in the diocese?
Yes, my understanding that the chancellor of the diocese has been working on a planning project, and that this is something that their committee's been working on for a while. I haven't seen the details of some of what they've been thinking, but I look forward to working with them. I have, in my pastoral experience, been involved in a number of planning projects, and I know that's an ongoing challenge for the church. I don't know the Diocese of Springfield well enough yet to say any specifics about that, but I know that's something we'll need to look at, and